Together again. In case your situation Pleasant good night to everyone. Welcome to our Youth Week of Prayer. And as we are here tonight, we pray that you will be richly blessed as we look at the topic, to love is to forgive. Our presenter tonight will be Sister Fabayo Worrell. At this time, let us pray before we start our inspiration. Our most kind and loving Father, we thank you, dear Lord, for the mercies of starting another week. We pray that you will be with us as we blend our voices together in singing praises to your most holy name. Bring those who are on their way safely and bless those who are viewing us online. In Jesus' precious name, amen. We're going to start our inspiration with the song, Above All.
Good night
and welcome. You're free to come in and join us if you want. Yes, come in. Please come in. All right. We're going to sing hymn 109, Marvelous Grace of Our Loving Lord, Grace That Exceeds Our Sin and Our Guilt. Yonder on Calvary's Mount Outpour, there where the blood of the Lamb was spilled. Welcome. Covers us. Jesus covers us. And we will sing together hymn 412, 412, Cover with His Life.
Jesus, sinless is He.
the joy of pardon.
Long in the joy of
the Father's love for us.
Searing loss, the
Our scripture reading is taken from John chapter 21, verses 15 to 17. So when they had dined, Jesus said to Simon Peter, "Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me more than these?" He said unto him, "Yea, Lord, thou knowest that I love thee." He said unto him, "Feed my lambs." He saith to him again the second time, "Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me?" He said unto him, "Yea, Lord, thou knowest that I love thee." He said unto him, "Feed my sheep." He saith unto him the third time, "Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me?" Peter was grieved because he said unto him the third time, "Lovest thou me?" And he said unto him, "Lord, thou knowest all things. Thou knowest that I love thee." Jesus said unto him, "Feed my sheep." Here ends the scripture.
Going to sing our prayer song, but first Elder Julian will tell us what we will pray for tonight.
Yes, please. Tonight we are praying individually, and we are praying for forgiveness. This prayer session we are praying individually, and we are praying for forgiveness.
Lord, I need you.
Let us bow our heads for prayer. Our loving Father who art in heaven, we give you thanks for your goodness, your grace, your mercies, and your blessing towards us. Lord, we want to give you thanks for the opportunity where we can come together and come before your throne again in prayer. Lord, I ask you that you would be with us, guide and direct our thoughts, our words, and our actions. Lord, let our lives be in harmony with your will. Help us to continue to study your word. Help us to continue to allow the Holy Spirit to speak to our hearts. And when he speaks to our hearts, let us act accordingly so that all the glory may go to you and to your Son, Jesus Christ. Lord, I ask you to please forgive us of our sins and cleanse of all our righteousness. Lord, we know at times that we, as individuals, both young and old, are disobedient to your word and are disobedient to your Holy Spirit. And at times we may even be rebellious. When you say in your word that we can come boldly to your throne, confessing our sins, and that you will forgive us. Lord, help us to understand that you call us to forgive others. For you say in your word that if we cannot forgive others, you will not forgive us. For you give a parable of an individual who a king forgave him much, but then he had one who owed him, and he took him to court, basically to get what was his, not willing to forgive him. And then he lost that opportunity where he was forgiven because he was so harsh. Lord, help us as your believing people not to be harsh with each other as wrongs are done to us. Lord, help us by your Holy Spirit as you speak to our hearts. Help us to forgive those who may have done us wrong. For as we walk this Christian journey, time and time again, both individuals among us as members and individuals in communities wherever we may be, even our workplaces, may do things to us that hurt us. And you're calling us as a people to extend forgiveness to them. Lord, help us to understand that built into your plan of salvation, you have called individuals to forgive. For even your word says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And that's how you demonstrate your forgiveness towards us, because it's through this one, Jesus Christ, through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, that we can be forgiven by you, because he came and died for us. Lord, I ask you to guide and direct everything that we say and do. And Lord, help us to have that spirit of forgiveness in our hearts. And we know that when we are obedient to your commands, there are truly blessings in store for us. And there's blessing in store for us as your believing people, as your children, as you forgive each other. And help us also to forgive, but also to have that love for each other. For you have that love for us, as we have realized and time and time again in our lives, we see you demonstrating your love on every hand and on every side. So Lord, help us to reciprocate that love to others as well. As church members, help us to share that love among each other. For your word says, this is how men will know that you are my disciples, if we have love for one another. And also help us to demonstrate our love wherever we may go, in our workplaces, in our schools, on the street, in our churches, wherever we may be. Help us by your grace and by your Holy Spirit to demonstrate our love as well. So guide and direct tonight's proceedings, and may we continue to be blessed as you worship in the beauty of holiness. I ask it now in your Son's precious name. Amen.
We will now be favored with an item of special music by Sister Sophie Ann Ramsey.
My presentation tonight is entitled, To Love is to Forgive. Let's bow our heads for prayer.
The Heavenly Father, please be with me. May you speak to me, and may the members here and members online be blessed. Amen. Now, Bill Buckner was a first baseman and outfielder with a successful 22-year career in Major Leagues, who died in 2019 at the age of 69. Buckner led the league in doubles twice and finished in the top 10 in stolen bases twice as well. He was even a National League batting champion in 1980 and an all-star in 1981. However, there is perhaps no player in the MLB history whose career has been more defined by a mistake despite its merits than Buckner's. It was the fall of 1986. The Red Sox had a 3-2 lead in the series and were leading 5-2 over the New York Mets in the 10th inning. They were only 3 strikes away from winning the Fall Classic. But in the top half of the 10th inning of the Game 6, Mookie Wilson of the Mets hit a rollout to Buckner at first base, which slipped between his legs and reached the outfield.
The Mets believe this ball game is Shea.
Oh, brother.
3-2 to Mookie Wilson. Little roller up along first, behind the bag. It gets through Buckner. Here comes Knight, and the Mets win it. If one picture is worth 1,000 words, you have seen about 1,000,000 words. But more than that, you have seen an absolutely bizarre finish to Game 6 of the 1986 World Series. The Mets are not only alive, they are well.
The Mets scored to win Game 6 and then won the game to win the World Series. Buckner's mistake at a decisive moment catapulted him to the top of the list of the worst sporting mistakes in history. After his playing days, he even had to move from Boston to Idaho due to the explosive anger of those around him. Resentment between Buckner and the Boston fans lasted for decades, but things began to change when the Red Sox finally won the World Series in 2004 and also 2007. The power of forgiveness was displayed in 2008 when Buckner returned to the Parkway to throw the first ball of the opening game. There, he received a standing ovation that lasted 2 minutes that made him cry.
Now it's time to welcome the star who will throw our ceremonial first pitch on this day that we honor champions. And how happy we are that amidst this celebration and joy, this Red Sox alumnus has come back to join us. He amassed Hall of Fame caliber credentials in his 21-year Major League career, and the Red Sox would never have won the 1986 American League pennant without him. Won't you please welcome him back to Boston and let him know that he is welcome always. Number 6, Bill Buckner.
In the Old Testament, forgiveness means to practice forbearance, or pardon, or to lift up, take away, bear up, or carry, And in the New Testament, it means to release from legal or moral obligation or consequences, to cancel, remit, or pardon. Like Bill Buckner, the Apostle Peter made a mistake that can be placed on the list of the worst mistakes in history. For 3.5 years, Peter was following Jesus very closely and witnessed the great miracles performed by the Lord. Even he was subject of some of these miracles. It is said that on one occasion, after he spent the night trying to fish without any results, the Lord approached him and said, "Row the boat out in the deep water and let your nets down to catch some fish." The story goes that they did this and caught so many fish that their nets began ripping apart. Seeing this miraculous miracle in the Bible says that Peter knelt down in front of Jesus and said, "Lord, don't come near me, for I am a sinner." On another occasion, Peter was on that same Lake of Galilee, along with the other disciples, when a great storm came against them with such force that it threatened to destroy the boat. But in the midst of the storm, Jesus approached the frightened disciples walking on the water. When the disciples saw the person walking on the turbulent waters, they were terrified, and they thought it was a ghost, and they cried out in fear. But Jesus encouraged them with these words, "Do not worry. I am Jesus. Do not be afraid." This is the moment when Peter says, "Lord, if it is really you, tell me to come on the water." Jesus told him to come, and miraculously, Peter walked on the stormy waters of the Lake of Galilee. Matthew records another epic episode with Peter and James. Then Jesus asks, "But who do you say I am?" Simon Peter spoke up, "You are the Messiah, the Son of the living God." Jesus told him, "Simon, son of Jonah, you are blessed. You didn't discover this on your own. It was shown to you by my Father in heaven. So I will call you Peter, which means rock. On this rock, I will build my church, and death itself will not have any power over it." We can all agree that Peter was a great player on Jesus' team. Yet, at the decisive moment, he made a serious mistake. Just before crucifixion, Jesus addressed his disciples saying, "During this very night, all of you will reject me." At this statement, everyone looked at each other. Then Peter said, "Even if all the others reject you, I never will." Peter insisted again and again, "I will never deny you." However, later, he not only denied him, but he cursed and he swore that he didn't know Jesus. Yet, Peter denied his teacher. He denied him when he should have defended him. He cowardly denied the one who had called him and worked extraordinary miracles in his life. In the face of such an erroneous action, Peter was destroyed and ashamed. And what do you think happened next? Well, as you know, our Lord was crucified. His body was placed in a tomb, but on that third day, he was resurrected. And after his resurrection, he meets Peter again in the same place where years ago Peter had witnessed that miraculous catch. Let us look at the conversation the Lord had with Peter. This is in John chapter 21. When Jesus and his disciples had finished eating, he asked, "Simon, son of John, do you love me more than the others do?" Simon Peter answered, "Yes, Lord, you know that I do." "Then feed my lambs." Jesus asked a second time, "Simon, son of John, do you love me?" Peter answered, "Yes, Lord, you know I love you." "Then take care of my sheep." Jesus asked a third time, "Simon, son of John, do you love me?" Now Peter was hurt. Why would you ask me this three times? So he told Jesus, Lord, you know everything. You know I love you. Jesus replied, feed my sheep. Peter, like Bill Buckner, made a grave mistake that was recorded in history, but he also received the grace of forgiveness. The Bible has recorded the word forgive about 127 times, and there are about 35 examples of forgiveness in the Bible. But if your past has some failures or betrayals in it, remember, David was an adulterer and a murderer. Peter denied even knowing Jesus. Rahab, well, she was a prostitute. Simon was full of pride, and Paul tortured and killed Christians. Young men and young women, Peter's stories and all those other examples in the Bible teaches us that to love is to forgive. Notice that Jesus forgave Peter despite his mistakes and failures. And he forgave him because he loved him. You may have had made serious mistakes too, but the same Jesus who forgave Peter also extends his forgiveness to you. On the other hand, this story also teaches us to forgive just as Jesus did. The Lord gave Peter a second chance despite his mistakes. Likewise, you and I must be willing to forgive. Today, I invite you to receive forgiveness, but also give it. Never forget that to love is to forgive. Now, our reflection question. What can we learn from both Bill Buckner's story and Peter's story? This is to the congregation. What can we learn from these stories? That we will make mistakes, but there is grace. Anyone else? All right.
Both stories, the forgiveness was given. It's in Bill Buckner's story. Mm-hmm. It took a long time before the people forgave him.
Very long.
So it happens with us too today. Sometimes forgiveness takes long.
Okay. Can you explain in your own words why to love is to forgive? So to love is to forgive. Thank you very much.
At this time, we will have our second prayer focus as the prayer team comes to give our prayer song. And we'll be praying in groups of twos this time. And we are praying that we will be willing to forgive. We are praying in groups of twos, and we are praying that we will be willing to forgive.
We'll sing the chorus.
Oh God, how I need.
as we close our service tonight, we will sing the hymn, Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb.
Thank you for the cross, Lord. Thank you for the price you paid. Bearing all my sin and shame, in love you came and gave amazing grace.
The Lamb.